can turn the world on with a smile. You can take a nothing day and suddenly make it all seem worthwhile. What a true girl, and you should know it. Each place and every little movement you show it.
Love is all around.
No need to fake it.
You can never tell.
Why don't you take it? You're gonna make it after all.
Hi, everyone. Welcome back to the Jodie Emery Show. Today is Thursday, April 14th. And 420, April 20th, is less than a week away. Downtown Vancouver, we're having a massive event with a full stage and banners, and we're going to be reminding everyone how important it is to vote on May 2nd of this year to get rid of the Conservative government, because they would want to see every single person out on 420 in a prison cell for 420 years. I mean, the Conservatives don't like our culture, and we should use 420 to remind everyone that voting is essential to make sure that they don't get a majority government or we're in some big trouble. So make sure that you vote too. I'm going to be voting. Marc can't vote because he's in the U.S. So please get out and vote for him. Vote against a Conservative in Marc's place. That's really important, and I'll keep reminding everyone about it. I got some photos from Marc from our last visit down in Georgia before he was shipped out. They're really cute. I actually like this one the best out of all the photos that we've had together. And he wrote on the back, "I love this one. Love to my girl." April 1st on the 11th is when he sent it, as I get transferred. And he would be transferred out on April 4th, Monday. We have some other ones of us visiting here. And this visit was really special because we were able to hold hands again during our visit, and they hadn't allowed anyone to do that for a long time. So to sit there, to travel all the way down and sit across from Marc, and for me to be crying about something and him not to be able to hold my hand or even touch me in any way, that's kind of a strange torture in itself, to sit this close, you know, and not be able to even touch each other's fingers. So that was really hard, and I'm very grateful that they got rid of that rule. So for the last visit Marc and I had, we were allowed to hold hands. But the inmates at D. Ray James are still having a lot of trouble. I won't even go into the details, but now that Marc is gone, Geo Group seems to be willing to keep doing the terrible job that they were doing before. So that's a call for everyone to try and just stop the imprisonment of marijuana users and nonviolent people, because the prison industry is destroying lives. And if Marc's going to be moved around to different facilities like he is now, he's in Oklahoma City waiting to go to Yazoo City in Mississippi. But, you know, prisoners are all across America in horrible conditions, and maybe Marc will see a bunch of different places and bring the spotlight to these horrific injustices going on all across the United States. We have some breaking news in Canada. Really exciting news, actually. In Ontario, a good friend of ours and a contributor to Cannabis Culture magazine, Matt Murnaugh, had a decision returned on his case to the Ontario Superior Court. The judge decided that the medical marijuana access regulations in Canada, our legal medical marijuana program, was not constitutionally valid because it wasn't accessible enough for medical marijuana users. I have the story here from Cannabis Culture's website. Jeremiah, our editor, wrote it and posted it, so please go there to read it. But the judge did say that seriously ill persons who need marijuana to treat their symptoms are forced to choose between their health and their liberty. If they choose their health, they must go to significant lengths to obtain the marijuana they need, including lengthy trips to purchase the drug, resorting to the black market, and living with the constant stress that at any time they could be subject to criminal prosecution. And it goes on and on about all the ways that sick and dying Canadians are being mistreated by the government's medical marijuana laws. So the judge said that for 90 days, the government has time to create a new medical marijuana program where it's more available to people, where doctors have to sign forms or there has to be some other way to get a license to use it and produce it. And that's great news, because I don't think the government has a plan in place. The Conservatives want to get rid of this program anyway. They'd rather see sick and dying Canadians suffer than see them find the relief and the happiness they get from using cannabis. I mean, the Conservatives are going to fight this all the way, but the court court's ruling is very telling, and I think it's a good sign for people all across Canada. We have 90 days for something new to come into place, and the judge said that if that time passes and nothing new has been introduced to provide safe and widespread significant access to safe medicine, marijuana will be legal for everybody to possess it and to produce it. That's groundbreaking news. It's pretty big stuff up here in Canada. You can simply Google Canada marijuana and you're going to find a ton of news. And our good friend Matthew Murnau, his case was the one that went to court because he was busted for growing medical marijuana when he wasn't able to find a doctor. He's got fibromyalgia, scoliosis, severe seizures. So we're happy he's able to get the access he needs now because he's been given an exemption from the law. And many other people will soon be able to get more access too because Canada is going on a positive path in this direction. The courts are on our side. But if the Conservatives win this election, they're going to replace all the judges and the courts will not be as lenient. So you've got to be getting out on May 2nd to vote against a Conservative. I want you to write letters to Marc. He's still down in Oklahoma. He might be moved to Mississippi at any time, but he could be in Oklahoma for weeks or months. So please look at the address down below in the information bar and also at freemark.ca and send him a quick letter just to let him know you're thinking about him. Tell him about the exciting news. He's very excited about everything going on across the U.S. and Canada. So keep him informed with that and with your life. And hopefully we'll get him transferred back home soon. The decision is due any time now, and we haven't heard back from the U.S. government. So if you can write a letter or make a phone call to help get Marc transferred home, to pressure the U.S. government to send him home, go to freemark.ca. We have the address and exactly what you need to write. Please send a letter and help him get the approval to come home. I thank you all for tuning in. Go out there and celebrate on 420. It's a celebration of our culture, but it's also a time to remind everybody that all of us are at risk of having our lives destroyed by the war on cannabis and the prohibitions that are in place. And the only way to help save each other is to get involved in this system and change it from within. So thanks a lot. Do what you can do. Go to cannabisculture.com, whyprohibition.ca. Make sure you know that you're registered to vote. You can go to elections.ca for that. And stay tuned for more updates every week. Free Marc Emery.